As I scale, move, rotate, and duplicate this vector illustration, can you notice what is so different about it? Now I'm going to explain everything in today's video and offer some tips relating to one of Illustrator's brand new updates. Sponsoring today's video is Milanote, the best place to plan and streamline your next graphic design project. Milanote allows you to generate ideas and concepts with ease, and then to evolve those creations to final design solutions. As you probably know, I use Milanote myself for my design projects, and you can learn more about their awesome project planning software later in today's video, and just how helpful Milanote can be for your creative design process. So welcome back to Satori Graphics, everybody. And the eagle-eyed viewers out there might have noticed that as I scaled and moved objects, you are in full view of the design throughout the entire transformation. This is the new real-time drawing function built into Illustrator CC 2020 as of March. Now you can find the option in the performance settings, and there is a note here relating to lag, which I will go into later in today's video. But if I go ahead and turn off this function, which was the previous standard Illustrator function, when I scale the rectangle, we lose the color and the design of it as a whole, only seeing the vector path as we scale and move it. This isn't ideal to us designers, and I'm going to go into the advantages and some tips for this brand new update. Firstly, I'm going to list on screen every tool or function that is compatible with the new real-time drawing function. There are quite a lot of them, but in my opinion, there does need to be more, and a little later, we are going to see some of them that are not included on this list. So firstly, let's tackle stroke paths. Here, I have a round cap stroke line. By default in Illustrator, if I take the direct selection tool and move an anchor point or a handle or change the curve in any way, I only see the end result once I release the vector. For illustrators especially, this is annoying and it's not ideal for a solid workflow. With real time activated, we see the changes in, well, real time. The animation is so smooth between changes, and it just feels so neat and handy to be able to do this with our designs in Illustrator. Secondly, again with strokes, this time I have a single path but with three strokes built into the appearance panel. If you notice the thin grey inner stroke, I'm going to add some dashed lines to that stroke in the stroke panel, and I'm going to make two different sized dashes with two different gaps in between. Now again, using the direct selection tool, we can manipulate the stroke path, and we can even see the dashed lines being created or removed when making the path shorter and longer. It's a very powerful addition to Illustrator, and it's been long overdue if you ask me. I have heard of other vector programs out there having this kind of function already, so it was about time that Illustrator kind of stepped up to the game. It is cool though to finally see my favorite software have this function built in. And of course, if we revert back to the default, we see how clunky and how annoying it is to have the strokes disappear and become invisible until we release the vector. Now earlier I mentioned that the preference settings had a note attached to it for the real-time function. Now this note essentially means that if you're working with a design that has a lot of paths and a lot of anchor points, now we're talking a huge amount of them, Illustrator is automatically going to switch off the real-time drawing to compensate. Now to demonstrate this, I have a vector castle here, and if I press Command or Control Y and head into the outline mode, we can see the craziness of detail involved with this design. I do have real-time activated, but as soon as I go to resize the vector, we're not offered the real-time function because Illustrator has deactivated it for this specific design, simply because it has way too many anchor points. However, interestingly enough, when I move it around, I still have the ability to see the design in real time. But yeah, scaling and rotating causes a lag, and so Illustrator just shuts off the function. Now, a quick tip that you might want to take note of when working on designs with a degree of complexity is to hide the edges, which you can find in the drop-down menu here, as well as the keyboard shortcut next to it. One disappointing thing I realized is that the real-time drawing function is not compatible with the width tool. Pressing Shift and W will allow you to use this tool, and illustrators who use this program do make great use of this tool. However, the real-time drawing function doesn't work with it, which I feel is something Adobe should have made sure was something that could happen for illustrators especially. Moving on to something that does work, and that is gradients. Now, gradients never look so awesome being stretched, scaled, moved, and you know, just adjusted in real time. This is for sure going to help my workflow, and you can bet that I'm going to have this real-time drawing function switched on pretty much 24/7. But what do you make of this new update from Adobe, and will you be using it for your workflow? There are a few more updates that I haven't gone into today, but I probably will make a video at some point on those in the near future. But yeah, big thanks to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. I really do highly recommend it, and I've been using it for nearly 2 years now myself. You can easily streamline your creative process from start to finish on any project that you're working on, but also it's very easy to share your ideas and your projects with other clients or even work colleagues. So yeah, do check out the links down below for more information on Milanote and start streamlining your creative design process in a more efficient way today.
Make sure you have a great day, everyone, and of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.